Now, I was under the impression that when you were bad at a job and you got fired, it wasn't a cause for celebration. But let's have a look at what happened to Goebbels' lookalike, ex-Ukrainian defense minister. A round of applause as we see. But what's really interesting to note here is the EU flags that seem to be on display. Is it just in the EU that being incompetent means that you are praised? What does this actually mean? I've heard rumours that this dude might now be the envoy between Ukraine and the UK, despite the fact that he's so corrupt, he's too corrupt even for Ukraine. Like, surely at some point we need to look at people like von der Leyen, yeah? Terrible at her job, so became head of the EU Commission. And Joseph Borrell, similar. Annalena Baerbock, my goodness, has driven Germany into the ground, destroyed diplomatic relations wherever she goes, yet is promoted. Janet Yellen, Victoria Nuland, Joe Biden, all people who have shown great ineptitude at the jobs that they've done and then have been promoted. Why do we live in a society where we value people who are inept? Is it because they're yes men? Grant Shapps, perfect example again, failed at being the net zero British minister or whatever nonsense name they gave him. So they've now made him the UK defence minister, despite the fact he's not a military man and I believe has family in Ukraine. So massive conflict of interests. Why are we accepting a democracy that promotes ineptitude? I do not understand why and what this is about, because frankly, I would like to see a society where people who are good at their jobs get promoted, where people who have fresh, interesting, clear visions for the future get to talk about those visions in Parliament and have them discussed. This is a clear example of the EU taking in a man who has failed in his responsibilities. So it's fine, we'll have them. Do you know, I only wish I'd known this, because I would have been inept in all of my jobs and then maybe I would be earning lots of money now rather than living in a two-bed council house with three children, three animals and a husband, and hoping that TikTok doesn't completely destroy my channel anymore, because it's one of the few ways that I can earn money. You know, it's crazy to me. Crazy to me.